The Switch dock and its original charger are pretty hard to carry for many people who want to play Switch in TV mode anywhere. And today, ChargerLAB got a charging dock from HAGiBiS, equipped with an HDMI port, which can replace the huge dock and charger. It adopts the GaN components, so its size is much smaller. This charger can perfectly fit the traditional color of Switch. The brand logo is in here, and the Switch GaN dock is on the other side. All the specs info are printed on the red part, modulus TC-064. It can support input of 100 to 240 volts, 50 or 60 hertz, 1.5 amp, and the USB-C can support up to 60 watts, while the USB-A only supports 5 watts. The foldable prongs can make it more convenient to use. As mentioned, it comes with an HDMI port that can support 4K, and two USB ports are above it. And the size of this charger is about 59.5 by 47 by 30.5 mm. And the weight is about 122 grams. The ChargerLAB Power ZKM002C shows the USB-C only supports PD3.0 protocol, and it has 5 fixed PDLs of 5V, 3A, 9V, 3A, 12V, 3A, 15V, 2.6A, and 20V, 3A. Next, let's take it apart and see how it integrates the HDMI port inside. The red part can be easily removed by spudger, and then take out the internal PCBA module. The entire module is wrapped with a heat sink for heat dissipation. The small output PCB is soldered to the main PCB. Let's slowly remove the heat sink and the thermal pad of the PCB. The input and output filter capacitors and transformer are on the front. The primary mass controller and GaN transistor are on the back. ChargerLAB found this charger adopts QR flatback topology. There is a separate PCB on the main PCB for USB-C output and video conversion. The input delay fuse is 3.15 amp, 250 volts. Two bridge rectifiers are soldered on the back of the small PCB. The NTC thermistor is used to suppress the inrush current, and the safety X2 capacitor is next to it from DGCX, 0.22 microfarad. The common mode choke is wound with insulated wires. Two bridge rectifiers can convert AC into pulsed DC, marked with MSB407. They are connected in parallel to dissipate heat evenly, 4A, 1000 volts. The pulsed DC will be filtered by electrolytic capacitors and are from CyXincon, 22 microfarad, 400 volts. The differential mode choke is insulated with the heat shrinkable tube. Those two filter capacitors are also from CyXincon, 33 microfarad, 400 volts. Flip to the back, the primary controller is from Kiwi KP2202, a high-frequency quasi-resonant flatback PWM controller. This is the power supply capacitor for the primary controller, 10 microfarad, 100 volts. Here is the GaN power transistor from Innoscience, 650 volts, 0.20. The transformer's magnetic core is tightly wound with tape for insulation and marked with ATQ2515. The PC817 optocoupler is from Orient and is used for voltage regulation. Two blue wire capacitors are from DGCX. The synchronous rectifier controller is from Kiwi KP4060, which supports DCM, CCM, and QR. The synchronous rectifier is from AGM-Semi, 100 volts, 7.5 milliohm. Those two solar capacitors are connected in parallel for output filtering. They are from JSH PZ series, 680 microfarad, 25 volts. The building protocol chip is from iSmartware SW2303, which is a highly integrated IC that can support all mainstream protocols. The output VBUS MOSFET is from Vinsock and adopts DFN 3x3 package, 30 volts, 11 milliohm. The USB PD controller is from Fresco FL7102, used to output the DP signals. It integrates aux switch and VCON switch. The crystal oscillator for USB PD controller is 12 MHz. This chip is VLAB's VL170, used to output DP signals and USB signal. The video interface converter is from Parade, used to convert the DP signal from the USB-C board to HDMI signal. Here is the crystal oscillator for the Parade converter. Those two MOSFETs are used to control the USB-C board. The buck converter is from Nisway, which integrates MOSFET and is used for power supply of USB-A. This 10 microhenry inductor can work with the buck converter for output. Another buck converter is from Techcold with built-in MOSFET. This tiny chip is used for signal switching. Well, that's all components of this HAGiBiS charging dock. It actually combines the switch dock and charger into one. After taking it apart, we found it integrates the video signal conversion module to achieve this function. So you can conveniently play your favorite game in TV mode anywhere. Okay, that's all for today's video. If you like this video, please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. See you in the next video. Bye!